Good afternoon, coach. Good afternoon, player. Can you hear me?
Afternoon.
Cool. Okay, so let's begin today's PC. And yes. Kindly note that each media can ask per question, and if there is enough time, we'll come back to you.
I didn't understand it.
Each
media can ask,
one question at a time, and if there is enough time, we'll go back to the same media. Perfect.
Okay,
perfect. So we'll begin today's PC. Can I have the first question? Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Can I begin?
May I know who is this, please? You can.
This is Adar Sharif from Halfway Football.
Carry on.
Yeah. Hi, Coach. Hi, Jaisal. So, Coach, my question is to you. So, from what we have seen from the last three matches, KBFC looks a little bit disorganized in set pieces. So, what's your take on that?
Well, if you look at the last three games, I don't remember that we conceded goal on set pieces. So, looking maybe other teams or something, I think that, you know, especially the last two games, we have focus, we have concentration. Hopefully, we will stay like that because we need to be concentrating and focused in every possible aspect of the game. I think that every team, even looking at statistics from last seasons or also this season, many teams, they are conceding goals on set pieces. So far, it hasn't happened with us, and we will like to keep it so. So we will try to be tomorrow also focused and concentrate.
Okay, Coach.
Krishnan, you can go next.
Okay, thank you. Good afternoon, Coach. Good afternoon, Jaisal. I am Krishnan from... Yeah, I am Krishnan from Godson Football. So my question is to the coach. Our defense seems to be working well after the first match. But are we as a team still finding the balance in the terms of attack and defense?
You know, there is interesting thing in football. When you as a team, you want to play attacking football, to press high and everything, it opens some possibilities to your opponent. Then if you concede some goals, then, you know, the everybody starts speaking, you know, but the defense is poor. And then when you play defensively good game and you get create chances, then you say, like, you know, but we didn't score goals. And this is the football. So actually, in a football, you have to find correct balance between your defensive work, not to concede goals. Of course, the clean sheet is the best thing that you can have as a team. And also to create chances and score goals. So that's what we are trying to have. Correct between chances that we can create and not conceding goals. Like that, you can be a strong team. So actually, I think that many teams are suffering more than us in some aspects. So actually, we want as a team to work hard and harder on many things to become better and to be the team that that can participate in this ISL. So this is what we are going to achieve.
Thank you, coach. Thank you,
Krishna.
Thank you, Krishnan. Do we have any more questions?
Can I go next?
Yes, Hari.
Hello, Hari.
Hi, Coach. How are you?
Fine.
All good. Coach, I just want to ask about one particular player. I want to know a bit more about Chencho. So, Chencho has come in as a substitute for all the matches so far, and he has done well also. So, is that the role that you have identified for him? You know, something like a super sub?
No, not per se, because I think that all the foreign players we have, they have quality. And all of them, they have quality to be in starting 11. The fact and the bad thing from our side, also from the other club's side and perspective, is that there is the rule that you can only align four of them. But all of them, they are good. And I think all of them, they can participate in being starting 11. So for us as a coaching staff also is quite puzzling to find the correct formula. So I'm really happy with all of them. I'm really happy with only mentioned Chencho, but with all of them and the qualities they're having, and they show you in the training session. So actually, I like having them all together on the pitch, but it's quite impossible. So that's why sometimes you have to puzzle to one of them. So two of them being on the bench. So this is what we have to do.
Right, right. I have one more question. So finally, you know, are there any injury issues ahead of tomorrow's game? Like, for example, Setyasen, he hasn't been seen in the squad so far. What's up with him? And are there any other injury issues? Can you shed some light on that? You know, what's happening?
Yeah, of course. Setyasen, Setya had a small issue during one training session not long time ago. And we, with medical staff, we decided to prevent and anticipate certain things, because if we see the length and the short term of ISL, we want to avoid stupid decisions and stupid moments, throwing some players, how I say, in risk and making risk to miss later the whole ISL. So with Setia, we were prudent, we were very careful. He came back in training process a couple of days ago. He's fully available for tomorrow's game. So today we have training. So far, we didn't have any trouble, except Raul KP, who is already in a recovery.
All right, coach. Thank you so much. All the best for tomorrow's game. I have a question for Jessel also, if you don't mind.
Yeah, go.
Can I go ahead?
Yeah. You can go ahead, Hari.
Yeah, all right. So, Jessel, I just want to know, I mean, first of all, good job so far, as you have been among the most consistent performers for KBFC so far this season. So I just want to know, personally, how satisfied are you with your own performances and the performance of KBFC overall so far, you know, as a captain and as a player of the team?
For me, I'm trying my best to adapt as a coach wants me to play. And about the team, I would say, we are doing very well. We are adapting to whatever stats we are going through and whatever the plan is to play on the pitch and to win the matches, and we will do it. So I would say we will be there, but the plan is we are working on ourselves every day, whatever is good for the team, and knowing about the opponents who we play and doing whatever is needed to win the match.
All right, Jessel. Thank you so much. And all the best to both of you for tomorrow's game.
Thank you, Hari.
Thank you, Hari. Do we have any more questions?
Hey, coach. Can I go?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. I'm Anurag from RFTWC. Okay. So, Odisha FC have been scoring a lot of goals from set pieces. So, is there any specific, like, have there been any kind of specific preparation to stop this thing?
Well, of course, not only set pieces, but every other aspect. We played also against Odisha in pre-season. We played one friendly. We know that our tomorrow's opponent, they have quite some qualities. Speaking about set pieces, and of course, as a team, you have to prepare to face those things. So it is not only that we're going to do that, but this is one of the aspects that we are preparing. So of course, every game you have to prepare to be strong against anyone you're playing.
Okay. Thanks a lot, coach. All the best for the game.
Thank you.
Adarsh, you can go next.
Hi, coach. So, coach, I have one more question to you. Like, as there are many more talented players like Gil and Sandeep, etc., in the team, so what's your plan regarding them? And will there be rotations in the squad to accommodate their place in the starting 11?
You know, if we speak about goalkeeper position, I rather give that. Decision and authorization to our goalkeeper coach, because he's the guy who's working with them, knowing all possible details, and with the cooperation with him, we make those decisions. So we are really glad that to have many youngsters who have potential to grow up to become important players of ISL League and also Kerala Blasters. You name just a couple of them. Also, many of them, like we had in the last couple of games, Vinci, or Gibson or Ayush or Jorge Palm. We have many youngsters who are trying to find their way, and probably in the next next period, our goal and our objective is to give those boys time to play and you know, having them on in ISL. So this is our goal. Hopefully, we'll see them soon.
Okay, coach. Thank you, coach. Thank you, Jessel, and all the best for the next match.
Krishnan, you can go next.
Hi. I have a question to Jessel. Like for last three games, I have seen that you have the freedom to go for the attack also, like rather than staying behind, you can go and participate in the attack. Are you enjoying that freedom given in that system?
Yes, I'm enjoying it very well.
Thank you.
He can do whatever he wants.
Yeah, that's what I want to ask him. Like, I have seen him attacking more for compared to last season. I have seen him attacking more, and that's actually, in my opinion, that's his best game. So that's why I asked him, like, whether he's enjoying.
My job is first to defend and then to attack. So if I get a chance to go and attack, I will not hesitate to do it. And I like it. I like to play like that. So it's my game, and he, coach knows me, and he gives me the freedom to go up. And if I get a chance to go up, I will go up.
Thank you. Thank you, Jasal. Thank you. All the best for next game. Thank you,
Krishna.
Thank you, Krishna. Do we have any more questions? Yes, Ashwin, you can go ahead.
Good morning, coach. Good morning, Jasal. Ashwin from Zilis.
Hello, Ashwin.
So my question is to coach, we all know about Nishu right now. Nishu has been fit recently, and he's in playing condition. But whenever we've seen him playing, he's come in left wing position. But his natural position, as preferred position, as we all know, is playing as a wing back. So, are we going to see Nishu as a wing forward or a wing back in coming games, considering the situation and considering the results of the previous games that we have attained?
First of all, we have to be happy, and we are really glad that Nishu has been back, you know, after such a long period, after such an unpleasant period for Nishu. He's back with the team, and he started building up his fitness level, all the things that he was missing in the previous 6-7, I think even longer. And now he's in a period of improving, and he's a period of getting better and better every day. As a coaching staff, as a team, we are very happy to have many players who can be very performant on different positions, like it's the case with Nishu. We can also name several players from our team. If we speak about Vinci, if we speak about Stalin, if we speak about many of them, they can play on different positions as a wing back or as a winger. So with Nishu, we started with that kind of idea, because also if you are now starting back as offensive player, we'll be more concentrated maybe on the attacking things then rather than covering the whole length, defensive and offensive. So like that, you increase the level, you increase your responsibility, everything possible on the pitch. He's quality player, you know it very well. He's a national team player. He used to play for national team. He used to play games in ISL, scoring goals. So from our point of view, we're happy to have that kind of player back. So now it's up to him to build up his self-confidence further on, his fitness, his strength, and to become an important part of our team. So probably in the next period, we'll see him on different positions because he can do it.
Okay, thank you, coach. And one more question. You actually mentioned earlier that the selection of the goalkeeper into the starting lineup is the decision of the goalkeeper, coach, or is it's his fortress or it's his decision whenever it comes to selecting a goalkeeper for the starting lineup? Are you satisfied with the performance of Albino right now?
Yes, not only with him, we are satisfied with all the goalkeepers and improvement, because since we started, it's a huge improvement to all of them. But like I say, the job of goalkeeping and goalkeepers, the job of goalkeeper coach, they are, let's say, the world apart, and the part of the training that they spent with their work, of course, later on in cooperation and let's say conversation with goalkeeper coach, we make decisions. But, you know, when we speak about technical things, about goalkeeping, the goalkeeper coach is the guy who knows it better. So that's why we have goalkeeper coach and goalkeeping good job. So actually, when we speak and make the decisions together, of course, I like to listen to my goalkeeper coach, who is the specialist in that job.
Okay, great, coach. One more question to you, probably the last one.
Yes.
We have seen in the previous game that the first game where you opted for one center back and went for three foreign players at the front, we scored two goals. And the next game, we came out with two center backs and we made chances, but we couldn't convert to solid chances like the one Sahel got and many more chances like that. We couldn't convert them and we drew the game, which we actually could have won. And against BFC, when we see, I actually personally, in a personal perspective, I saw Alvaro making a lot of space and asking for the ball. And I felt like if any one of the ball reached Alvaro, he could have been buried any one of the chances and we could have won the game actually. And in third game, we didn't have any midfielder supplying that pass, that one creative pass. Only one pass could have done the job and we couldn't get that one pass to Alvaro. Is this killing the tempo of the game or tempo of the system that you're building in Kerala Blasters there? How much is this costing each and every mistake costing us in every game?
No, but you have to know that if you speak about first game against ATK, we were, let's say, in a situation not to have one foreign central defender. So we opted for that option. And we were playing with more foreigners in offensive compartment. We were playing offensive football. We were creating nice chances. We scored two nice goals. Yet we conceded four goals. Even speaking about penalty mistakes, referees' decisions, offside or not. No, I don't want to go back on that because, you know, we cannot control refs, their decisions whatsoever. So these kind of things, I don't want to bother. Then if we speak about game against Northeast, I firmly believe that we should have won that game because we were better on the pitch. We had chances to, like we say, kill the game and get those points. It didn't happen because we were not quite precise and efficient in the last moment where some of our guys, they should have scored goals. In the third game, you know, as a coaching staff, you take in consideration the level of fatigue, three games in 9 days, and then having 1 day less to recover than your opponent, who is, by the way, good on the ball, good team, plenty of national team players. And then, you know, sometimes as a coach, you change approach. As a team, you change approach. And we wanted to explore something else. I think in the last game against BFC, we had our moments. We had the chances. And even if you look statistically, we were more in the last third of Bengaluru FC than they were in our last third. But yet again, they had a couple of moments. We had moments where we needed to explore the space better. We were missing that last pass quality, decisive pass that some of our players could have scored goal, but that's football. Like I said, there are many aspects accumulating, like three games in 9 days, fatigue, and then players in one moment when they have to make that decisive pass or last quality touch, we were missing that in the last game. So we had our moments. Maybe we could have scored goal before that. I'm glad that we, on the fitness level, we were good. And so far, if you look at any other games around level of injuries, level of fatigue, cramps, whatever, we are glad that from our side, we never had a fitness problem. We never had a problem with the players after the game reclaiming the fatigue or cramps, because we are happy so far. And we want to improve in that way. Now, as a team, depending on our opponent situation, we are creating our strategy. How are we going to play? So this is the things that we as a coaching and medical staff, we are dealing with. So I think that we played three games against strong opponents, especially seeing the last season. And like that, you have to be clever because you see all around ISL how many mistakes are committed, how many goals after mistakes, how many goals after set pieces. So like we said at the beginning, as a coaching staff, you have to deal with all these things to find the correct balance. And of course, collecting points and being competitive. This is our goal.
Okay. Thank you, coach. And what about Chencho? Like, everyone wants to see Chencho up front, but he's coming in the last minutes, last 5 or 2 minutes. Do you think he deserves more minutes, or it's just the part of the game that he should come in last and provide that energy to the team?
No, I mentioned before, I'm very happy with his performance. I'm very happy with his work. He's one good player. He's one very good player. Quick on the ball, quick in decision. But like we said, so far our decision based on four players, it was that we were playing with some players in defensive block, some players in front. And I'm really sorry that as a coach, we can only align four foreign players. But he's a quality player and we like him having in our team. And hopefully now, maybe in the next period, we will see he'll be playing more and more.
Thank you, coach. Thank you, coach. Thank you, Jason. Best of luck for tomorrow's game.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ashwin. I guess that's the end of today's PC. We are wrapping it up here. Thank you, coach, for joining. And thank you, Jessel, for joining. Good luck for your next match.
Thanks.
Thank you.